don't do your proportions correct, if your perspective's out, it's always going to be out. Sometimes I end up making stuff up.
Get a gap.
Yeah. What am I doing? I want to see the window in there. Yeah. Some of these windows aren't level with the others, all over the place. It's a trying with something like this, something you notice. Window in there, a couple of windows in here. You start drawing something, you start seeing all the different windows. And I'm going to put a flag on it as it isn't on the picture. So I suppose I shouldn't make it the Scottish flag really. There we go. Okay, let's put some detail in the windows. Very loose, I'm not counting the window panes. Just moved the flagpole slightly. We've got a few little figures on there. Let's just do a few little people popping over the parapet. Get a sense of scale.
I can see
the door
cover their eyes on.
There are all sorts up there. Let's finish that bit off there. Anything later on, but I'm not putting the street lights in. I don't find anything else that should be in there. I'll put them in later on after I've painted. Okay. I'm getting a bit fussy now. Yeah, I don't put clouds in. That'll do. So have a look. Pass it around. So I've got it to a stage now where I think I've got enough pen on it. What I'll do after we've had our break, so I'm going to start painting. Okay, so if you haven't already done so, you can
still work.
Start finishing the pen work
on.
Or some
like
starting
like
the pen
stick
work.
Then.
Yeah.
Is it?
Okay, you can have a close look at mine as it goes around.
Yeah.
Right, do you want to come around my distance? Right, so I'm going to start painting now. Now, what I do to simplify things in terms of pen and wash and basically a shorter space of time is I always limit myself to the three steps, like a drawing, colour, shadow. I've done the drawing, I'm going to go colour next. When that's dry, I'll put the shadow on and that'll be it. Okay, and that stops me fiddling. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is just splash some sky on. Now, the brushes I'm working with here are a Sable Synthetic Blend. These are Rosemary & Co. I like these because they're fairly robust, so I can get some colour going. But they do hold more than the nylon. We've got more control over these. Right, so first of all, a little bit of water on the sky. I'm going over diagonally, that way I don't get a straight edge at the bottom. I'm quickly going to get a bit of cobalt blue out. I prefer cobalt blue for skies. And then just drop some in, scrub it in. And try not to follow the building so that you get a halo. So some of the blue goes up to the building and then others is a white cloud. Work quickly, as it will dry quickly. We've got a square there, we don't want a cloud of corners. Right, take a piece of tissue, if you want any more clouds, screw it up and just put some in. There you go, simple. Right. So whilst that's drying, I'm going to get the colours together that I think I need for the castle. Now, I'm going to go with a raw umber. These colours, by the way, these are tube colours I've got in here. Okay, if I was out and about, I'd be working with my pans, which are more or less the same sort of colours. I've got Winsor & Newton Artist Quality tubes. I've just dried out. I pre-wet them when I first got them out of the box, so I've got raw umber. Now what I don't want to do is just to paint with one colour all the way over, because that's boring. Okay, the castle's a little bit black, as most of the buildings are in Edinburgh. Okay, but what I want to do is just get a bit of stronger raw umber, is get a little bit of ultramarine burnt sienna. It's too much brown, let's put a bit more blue in. What that gives me is what I call a neutral tint. You can buy a neutral tint, but it gives me something that's fairly neutral. It's not too blue, it's not too brown. I don't use Payne's Grey very often, I tend to mix my own. And I stick some of that in with the raw umber in the corner. I've now got a subtle change between the yellowness of raw umber and a colder version with some of that grey in it. Okay. And if you want to make it slightly yellower, which is in places, you can bring a bit of raw sienna in. Let's make the raw umber a little bit stronger. Right, make sure you've got enough. You don't want to stop halfway through. Let's start painting. So you paint a little bit. Switch to the grey. I'm working around the windows because they are lighter than the brickwork. Change colour. I'm going to touch of this grey in somewhere. So I'm constantly changing the colour.
Do you ever use masking fluid?
Sometimes, but not very often. No. I use it very, very occasionally for maybe doing, I don't know, the flagpoles, for instance, they could have been, these ones here could have been done in masking glue. So constantly changing the colour. Let's put in a bit of raw sienna and make it a bit yellow. Change the colour. Just change the colour as you go along. Don't do it one colour all the way over, then come back and start changing the colour. Because that's when you get your backflows and your cauliflowers. This is where I can get the actual painting of it done fairly quickly. It's a bit silhouetted in places, but let's see how we go. So this is just the basic colouring that I'm doing here. I'm not worried about shadows just yet. Clean my brush every now and again because I've got three different colours on it. Roof to put in there, which is a slightly colder colour. Touch more ultramarine in it. And if you do this quick enough, I mean, we're lucky that most of this castle is more or less the same sort of colour, but if things start bleeding, I never worry about that because the pen mark holds the whole thing together. Okay, the rock is a very similar colour. But it's got a lot more grey in it, so let's start painting that similar colour and bring more of this in. Need to stir this now and again. So this is not shadow, this is just the colour of the rock. Okay, green. Take a bit of yellow. This is aureolin. You can use a capping yellow, pale or transparent yellow. A bit of ultramarine. And again, I don't want the same green all the way over. I want to vary it slightly. So I can use this, a little bit brown in this colour. So a bit more ultramarine into my grey. And let's make my greens a little bit stronger.
What colour do you use for your grey again?
It's ultramarine and burnt sienna. If you haven't got burnt sienna, you can use burnt umber. At a push, you can probably use one of the really warm reds, like a light red, Cadmium red, deep. You might be getting more purple on it, but you still get a grey. So in with my yellowy green, pick a bit more blue up. Back to the yellowy green. Blue up. Nearly got enough. I like aureolin because it's relatively transparent, it's not as opaque as a cadmium. And it's not as acidic as a lemon. Okay. Tree down there, but I'm not really going to worry about it. Don't worry about your edges. Never worry about your edges, I don't want square edges. What nice loose edges. Yeah. Simple. What I would suggest, do your sky wet and wet. Whilst that's drying, get all the colours ready that you need. Okay, and the most important thing, you don't just paint with one colour. Okay? So you get raw umber out, mix your grey up. Ultramarine and burnt sienna. Add a bit of that to your own. You can do it. Okay, I'm going to finish mine off. See, because we're running out of time. So, if you want to come down my desk. This is dry, nearly. Okay. So, shadow-wise, there's two things. First, I could use my grey that I mixed up as shadow colour. There's two different types of shadow. There's cast shadow and there's shadow created by things that are out of the light. So what I can do to begin with is to go back with my original raw umber, a little bit stronger, a little bit of the grey in there. And I can paint some of these in shadow. So they're away from the light. The light's coming sort of this way. Change it every now and again. So I'm actually I'm doing exactly the same, but just making it stronger. So this is curved, so this is a little tricky. Stronger at one end and then fade it off. This is what really brings out the three-dimensional quality of what you're doing. Getting a bit clumsy this brush, so I'm going to switch to my number 4. Same type of brush, it's just a smaller but it's longer. It's number 4, it's twice as long as normal number 4. Let's mix up a stronger variation of ultramarine and burnt sienna. I've basically got almost a Payne's grey colour. Do some cast shadows. All the clothes that the people are wearing on the wall now. Really got your imagination. It's a bit darker in here. Let's do some texture on the rock. You could of course go in with your pen and put a bit of texture on the rock if you want to. I'm not going to do much more than that. And I'm also going to put a little bit of blue sky in the windows, a bit of cobalt. Brightens it up a bit.